had sought to overturn Oblivion by granting unto it a role, a duty, an identity. I speak of the dragon. By the great will does the dragon create a cycle, allowing it to forestall the end of this world time and time again. Yes, there is. This world has been safeguarded by the dragon. You yourself were chosen to form a part of this cycle. The Arisen is selected by the Great Will to play the role of the dragon's counterpart. That is how this world is built. The dragon serves to continue the cycle, and the Arisen exists to oppose it. This is the true meaning of the dragon's oath. Once everyone in this world had a role to play. For a well-crafted tale has no excess, there must be a reason for each character's inclusion. This means that should even one of these characters stray from their assigned role, the tale entire will unravel. And if it does, their world will end. Such is the choice you have made, Arisen. By rejecting your own duty in this world, you have robbed all others of the chance to fulfill the roles they each signed. The pawns are no exception. Born in the nothingness of the world, they were granted the power of leading the perpetuation of the cycle. Yet, left to the dragon, that role has been unwritten. And there is surely no fate more pitiful than that.
Arisen, I am no longer a mere vessel. Your great will has imbued me with the lesser will of my own. Will is power. 'Tis the means to shape the world as one desires. Master!
Oblivion fades. This tale's end has been unwritten. My heart, it aches. A new world comes. A new tale is set to unfold. Yet, it seems I will not be there to watch it.